Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In case you are new here, in this channel I present recipes that do not require any kind of frying, roasting, cooking, in fact no kind of heating is necessary, just raw recipes, healthy recipes. But then I post food recipes almost on a daily basis, but then during the weekends once in a while I would like to present some talks and share my views on health, philosophy and so on. So this is one such topic today. I want to discuss about the economics of being on a raw food diet. Now many of you might have a feeling that living on a raw food diet, which predominantly consists of having dry fruits and fruits, could be quite expensive. At the end of this video, I would like to show you actual numbers based on which I've been living on raw food diet for the past 2.5 years at this point of time. So please continue listening. There is no second thinking that, you know, dry fruits are expensive. You know, rice could be costing, I don't know, I've not checked very recently, but then probably 100 rupees plus will be, you know, a kg of rice. Whereas cashew or almonds, you know, at the minimum they will be around 1000 rupees per kg. When someone is eating food that is primarily based on this kind of expensive food, how expensive does it get? Now what happens is, although you are eating richer food, you are not adding a lot of other ingredients which are used in cooked food. When somebody is eating cooked food, for example, certain people fry their foods to some degree. The consumption of oil is high. Lot of spices are used. Lot of pulses are used. In the case of non-vegetarian, you know, probably the meat is there, which is expensive again. So in addition to consuming vegetables, which is required in any kind of diet, they consume various other kinds of ingredients also, and that becomes part of the regular expenditure on a monthly basis. When primarily somebody is revolving on raw food, then you are eating only these items. If I compare the kitchen area that is used for raw food in my case to the one that we use for rest of us in the family, the number of ingredients that I hold are significantly less. I think, you know, there will be probably a fourth of them. So therefore the cost of consumption of these ingredients also reduce, and therefore the raw food doesn't work out to be as expensive as one would expect it to be. On a regular basis, you know, many families consume snack items such as cookies. What is my replacement in that case? You know, I could have something like this. That's a Ash God cookies that I've made recently. There's a video if you have not watched it already. So what does it contain? It contains Ash God, which is not very expensive though. That's a vegetable. And then I used quite a bit of almond pieces, flax seeds and so on. So the almond that is used probably consists of about 50% of what you see here, or maybe 40% of what you see here. So yes, this cookie is expensive. But then, if you try to see and compare that with the biscuits or the rest of the cookies that you buy commercially, there is a transportation expenditure, there is a manufacturer profit expenditure, there is a processing expenditure, you know, there are taxes involved, you know, it becomes quite expensive. You are not paying for the ingredients themselves, but then you are paying a lot more on the rest of the stuff. When I use the ingredients right away and then make my recipes, actually it doesn't work out to be so expensive. That is one part. The second part is, when I consume primarily raw food, it's a richer food. you know, you do not require to eat so much as you eat with the regular kind of carbohydrate based food. When you are consuming food that is primarily based on dry fruits, so the kind of energy that I get is, I think predominantly I get 50% of my energy probably from fats and 50% from vegetables and fruits. That's how I would put it. I have not made a study of that, but I think roughly it will fall within that. So when you are eating this kind of food, the dry fruits may be the only expensive part. The rest of the ones are not so expensive. Vegetables are not so expensive. Fruits are not expensive, particularly if you are consuming fruits which are seasonal in nature, then they are not so expensive. And I actually strongly recommend, even otherwise, to consume vegetables and fruits that are seasonal in nature. Nature provides these vegetables and fruits at that particular region, at that particular time, because that is the one which is best suited for the animal human consumption during that period. So when you buy seasonal foods, which is the largely produced item at that time, they are not so expensive. Nowadays, for example, I consume a lot of watermelon. Watermelon is quite cheap, as you know. I consume bananas on a regular basis. That's not so expensive. I consume papaya on a regular basis. That's not so expensive. I consume pineapple on a regular basis. That is not so expensive. I purchase and consume carrots in a big way. That's not expensive. I consume beetroots. That's not expensive. I occasionally use cucumber. I do not like cucumber, as a matter of fact. Except in during summer, I wouldn't take. But then when you do take, that's not expensive. So what I'm trying to say is, although it may look like, and honey, you know, many of you feel that, you know, honey is quite expensive when you are regularly using it. Yes, it is probably quite expensive when you compare it with sugar. But how much honey do I consume in a day? My consumption of honey in a day probably will be 2, 3, 4 teaspoons. I don't think it is more than that. So therefore, you know, when you put all of them together, that your diet is primarily considering these items which are eaten in a raw fashion without adding the other overheads, then it is not so expensive. So I actually will try to pull out some numbers and let's see how they come out to be based on how I have recorded my expenses. So I use an expense app in my iPhone called Income OK. So in this I regularly record all kinds of expenses and income that I have. And if I go through this for the current year 2020, which is where we are in May, and May 31st, I guess that is what it is. Okay, the raw food, the groceries for, and the groceries and the vegetables and fruits, everything I included in one item called raw food. The total expenditure for this is 23,420 rupees as on today. So let's say 23,000 roughly, or let's say 24,000 roughly. Now out of this 24,000, if I sort it by amount, I see that there was one item, dehydrator, for 3,999, which is an asset really speaking. Once you buy it, you use it for a long time. So if you remove that 4,000, you know, 24 out of 24,000, then you are left with 20,000. This is 5 months. So 20,000 divided by 5 months is 4,000 rupees. This is my average cost for the year 2020. Now let us see how does it show up when it comes to 2019. 47,219. And I did not purchase any big assets last year. So I know all of this is basically my profit expenditure. So, so 47,000 change 200, so let's call it as 48,000. 48,000 divided by 12 is 4,000 again. Oh wow, that's a very accurate representation, I guess. So this year also I have spent 4,000 rupees per month on an average, and last year also I have spent 4,000 rupees per month on an average. But as you can see, raw food is not so expensive at 4,000 rupees per month. Even after considering that I am primarily consuming cashews and almonds and pistachios and, you know, dates and then, you know, high quality honey sometimes, not every time, but then, you know, mostly I buy decent quality of honey. So if you consider all of these also, it is not so expensive. So living on raw food, you know, doesn't work out to be so expensive, really speaking. You know, so if you have, any of you have a feeling that it is expensive, you know, these are the numbers that confirm that it is not so expensive. I did some recent study on how much I spend on my raw almond milk. My milk is primarily composed of, made of almonds. And I was calculating and I was astonished to note that, you know, I spend almost 1,000 rupees for 1 cup of coffee every day for 30 days. It's quite expensive, but that is the only one, you know, a single item which is so expensive. But then all in all, like you saw, the rest of it falls under 3,000 rupees. So that's like 4,000 rupees per month is not so expensive. So I would like to strongly encourage you to move on to more and more of raw food. Do not be under the impression that living on raw food is expensive. It is the contrary. It's not so expensive. It is actually cheaper, as you saw, you know, the rest of the family, it's about 8,000 rupees, while this is 4,000 rupees. So please, I strongly encourage to move on to raw food, not only for economics reasons, which I have explained in this video, but more than that, the health reasons. Because you are saving a lot on the medicines, right? The diagnostic, the surgeries, and then the medicines that people perennially buy. All that will not be required at all. So living on raw food is a practical possibility for most of the middle class families. I strongly believe so. Friends, thanks for watching this video. I hope it was useful to you, and if it did, I hope it will encourage you to move on to more and more of raw food. And while you are there, please click on that like button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done already. It does help in a big way. And also do let your friends know, put your comments below. You know, a lot of activities are required on YouTube videos for them to show up for search results when others search on food items or anything that they search on. So I encourage you to put some comments, show some activity on this video so it is useful to everyone. Thank you again.